go see.
Betty Cash, Vicky Landrum, and her 7-year-old grandson, Colby, are hoping to play bingo.
I told you it'd be closed.
Well, we'll try again next week.
Right.
Come on, kiddo.
Come on, let's go.
But tonight, they're out of luck.
Hey! Y'all right? Y'all right? Okay.
Come on, let's head on home.
They'd forgotten that it was the holidays. There were no bingo places open. They tried two. Neither one was open that night, and they gave up eventually and decided they were going to drive home. They were in what's called the Piney Woods area of Texas, and it wasn't well populated. They were driving on essentially a county road.
Are you sure you know where you're going, hon?
Of course I do.
Driving, they see something bright in the distance, low to the ground, through the treetops, that is hard to distinguish, you know, what this is. All they know is it's very bright.
It's a plane coming in.
They thought maybe this is just some ordinary aircraft that's approaching on a particularly strange flight path, or perhaps taking a pass over the countryside.
Houston Intercontinental Airport was down south of them by maybe 30 or 35 miles, and there were some military and other facilities, you know, relatively nearby.
They drive for more than an hour along a dark road, but the object never leaves their sight.
Grandma!
Betty, that ain't no plane.
As they drove even closer, they saw this was definitely not an aircraft. It was a diamond shape of some sort, hovering just above the road.
Stop the car!
More unusual is what was coming out of it, these lightning bolts that seemed to radiate.
They may have been only 100 to 150 feet from it at that point. She thought about turning around.
They thought that perhaps the lightning was somehow interfering with the electrical system in the car because it seemed to be failing.
Okay, I'm trying.
The Cash Landrum sighting is one where the witnesses wanted to flee and they couldn't flee because they were stuck on this narrow road. And the UFO wasn't going away and they were in a stalemate.
Whatever the cause, the engine is dead. And the three passengers are going nowhere.
This is actually quite common in some of the close encounter cases in UFO literature, where there seems to be vehicle interference caused by electrical fields, perhaps from some kind of magnetic fields. Cars and trucks and other vehicles are affected by the presence of a UFO. In some cases, the witnesses feel that they themselves were picked out of a crowd or selected for whatever reason.
Wait a minute, Betty. Wait a minute.
Like many people in Texas, then and now, Vicky Landrum was a very religious, a very devout Christian.
Maybe it's okay. You think it's safe? Yes, Betty. Yes, I do.
This was so dramatic that she thought that this might have been Jesus' second coming.
As the three witnesses gaze at the shape above them, the temperature seems to rise.
There is some heat coming off of the craft. Perhaps there is some microwave radiation coming off of this particular vehicle that was causing everything in the surrounding area to be increasing in temperature.
It continues to get hotter and hotter. Vicky runs back to the car, and when she tries to touch the door handle that opened the car door, it's too hot.
Kitty.
She realized it wasn't Jesus. You know, she thought it was something else. Whatever that something else was, it wasn't God. Betty finally decides that I've got to get back in the car myself.
The temperature inside the vehicle was almost like an oven.
Suddenly, it had a roaring flame coming out the bottom that was directed toward the ground and that wasn't constant. Craft rose into the air, still with this flame, and began to slowly move away into the distance.
As the craft leaves the area, the car's engine comes back to life.
When Vicky pressed her hand on the dashboard, she had to pull it away because it was very, very hot. It burned her hand, and it did, in fact, leave a mark suggesting that the vinyl was scorching hot. When this object left, the witnesses described seeing up to a few dozen fairly large vehicles flying with it, perhaps escorting it somewhere.
So many of them.
They were more helicopter-like than anything else.
They seemed to be flying along with the UFO as it went into the distance, as if they were shepherding it, as if they were, you know, part of a whole entourage, as it were, flying away.
Was it a military operation, perhaps a secret operation, something that was classified and yet was accidentally seen by these three witnesses in a rural part of Texas?